Welcome to Popcorn Planet. We are live, and I guess I'm pissing off half of my audience. I don't know why, but I needed to talk about this topic, and we got so heated in the chat that I thought, you know what? I'm clipping. I'm making this video, and I hope you will support and click on more of these videos that aren't just Brian Laundrie. Steph, I want to talk about Dave Chappelle. I'm so glad Steph, the alternate, is here to get with me because we're both heated on this topic. This Dave Chappelle thing is blowing up into a bigger story that I don't think a lot of people are really paying attention to, and I don't see a lot of people defending him out there. I did go look. Channing Tatum just came out to defend him out of nowhere. So I want to put my voice and defend him because, look, I watched The Closer. Do I believe some of it was offensive? Yes. Do I believe it was more offensive to one group or the other? No. I've watched a lot of Chappelle. He hits everybody. If there's one group of people he hates the most, it's white people. He's made that joke in the special and in general. That's who he's criticized the most. As a white person, I laugh every single time. I want to hear his insight. I think he's very wise. Do I think he's always right? No. Do I think some of the things he said were offensive? Sure. But will I defend his right to say it? Yes. It's absolutely incredibly important that we protect our arts. And Steph, we were beginning to talk about this, and I saw a comment and it set me off. I saw a comment that was like, oh, I thought this was a liberal podcast. I got to get out of here. What? First of all, how dare you assume to know what my politics are? Second of all, as I've said previously, how is defending the arts from censorship not the most liberal thing you could do, Steph? I'm losing my mind. Since when did defending art and comedians and talent become not a liberal viewpoint? Like, am I crazy, Steph? Or am I for losing my have we all just lost our history and everything? It's all just become some garbled mess that we've lost the point of defending arts from censorship is the most important thing? Am I correct?
Oh, no. It's not about losing history. Haven't you heard? It's about rewriting history at the moment with these morphos, as far as I'm concerned. It's like, oh, they defend free speech. They defend the freedom to protest. They defend this.
They must support
that.
Trump.
Well, yeah. But then when you've got a comedian that is being critical and making jokes, as Dave Chappelle did in this special that was not to their liking. Oh my goodness, pitchforks to the ready. We must cancel this dude. Mofos, you all need a freaking reality check and your head knocking together because, yeah, you might be angry at Dave Chappelle, but keep up the same energy with people like Richard Pryor back in the day. Eddie Murphy back in the day. Have you watched their specials? I'm sure you have. Hello? They were just as, let's say, offensive in this day and age. I mean, back then it was comedy. Now they would be cancelled for it and probably wouldn't even be able to do those specials in the first place, I would imagine. However, you know, you want to cancel Dave Chappelle? Okay, but keep the same energy with all those comedians as well. As Andy mentioned earlier on, George Carlin. Oh my goodness, that dude took no prisoners. I love George Carlin. But at the end of the day, it's a case of, well, he's making fun of a minority and I don't agree with that, so he must be cancelled. So if you don't agree with something, that automatically means their cancellation. How freaking dare you think that you have the power to be able to cancel anyone? It's like this internet's turned into a huge freaking kangaroo court. Hello, if he's broken any laws whatsoever, then do you know what? Ooh, newsflash, we've got a justice system to take care of those morphos. We don't need you to take care of them, right? We don't need your cancellation culture. We don't need your kangaroo court because we got a justice system that'll take care of them, yeah? How dare you think that you have more power than the justice system or equal power to the justice system where you think you have the right to cancel someone? No, 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 no. That shiz does not fly with me.
Well, and it's
you
a
disagree
scary
with him, that's absolutely fine, but that does not give you the right to cancel him.
Yeah, well, it's a scary thing because, look, everyone has the right to disagree, right? You don't have to support Chappelle. You don't have to go watch his special. You can be angry. You can say your piece. Say, I don't like it for these reasons. Great. I'm always a fan of education over condemnation, cancellation, et cetera. Like, if you believe there's something wrong with what The Closer, Netflix's special, was, if you believe there's something that we're missing that's actually why it's hatred, then get specific and watch it all. The biggest problem I have is so many people are criticizing the special, and I don't believe they've watched all. In fact, I have some more information about this. I talked to someone who was at the special, and they knew from people in Dave's camp and I'm not going to ref. I can't give away who my source was, but someone knows, you know, people in Dave Chappelle's camp. And what I gathered from when I spoke to them is like they're just kind of shocked. They're like, they just don't believe anyone is listening, like actually paying attention and hearing all of what Dave said. And as someone who watched the full special, again, was there stuff that was offensive? Yeah, sure, there was stuff offensive. But at the end of the day, I don't think they understand where he's coming from. To me, all this outrage is proving him correct. Because at the end of the day, these were jokes. These were absolute jokes. He's aimed at a lot of people, and that's what that was. And Steph, you're right. Every comedian, popular comedian ever in history has made fun of groups. It's always been what happens. And certain people in the trans community, they appreciate that. They're like, you know what? You making jokes about me legitimizes, like humanizes me. I feel like I'm actually part of it now that you're making, like, great. Just like you made fun of Italians or whatever it is. You know, like some people actually believe that about it. Chappelle talked about that in Sticks and Stones. And so this idea that everyone in this community agrees and says he's hateful and must be stopped and his special must be removed is really crazy. So I want to go through the timeline because I have something new here I want to share with you guys. And I appreciate you guys letting us do this topic. I hope it will support us getting other topics because look, do I believe people were offended by this? Sure. In fact, Netflix employees organized a walkout after CEO's bad response to basically the CEO of Netflix came out and defended Dave and said, we will support it. We're not going to bring this down. And I got to applaud him. Good. Support the special. Stand by it. Give your creators that empowerment. It's not like he's out there saying hate speech. That's not what he was doing at all. He was cracking jokes. If you're uncomfortable with it, criticize it. Fine. Don't watch it, fine, but demanding that it be pulled from Netflix? How dare you? No. And the reality was this wasn't a walk-off. This was a digital remote, like we're not going to be zooming in for an hour is what this really was. If you really believe it, then quit or, you know, do something more serious. But that's where this is where all stemmed. And the media has jumped on this. And then the latest that came in was people were sort of shaming it. Dave Chappelle's special costs more than Squid Game. Now, this information came out because the leader of this organization, who was doing all this stuff, an activist, leaked the information from Netflix. This person already showed up to meetings that they weren't allowed to be at, and then they started leaking information about the cost because of how important a topic they thought this was, leaked it to the press, and now we know how much these specials cost, which was a complete breach of trust for the company you work for. So they've acknowledged that, you know, the special costs about $24 million. And then they were able to prove that Squid Game cost, where was it? Squid Game cost less than that, 22 or something. I can't find it quick enough. But their sort of point here being like, why are we spending this much money for this hatred when the reality Bo Burnham's Inside scored, you know, was only cost $3.8 million? Why are we doing that? Well, because you pay Chappelle. Chappelle's a huge draw. He's giving you the news, and clearly a lot of people are paying for it. He's earned it. They want to have the exclusive tie to Chappelle because that's going to give them exclusive ties to other talent and comedians. Of course, that's part of Netflix's business model. And this idea that this activist knows better to how to run Netflix and now will reveal intel to try and win this argument, to me, really bothers me. So now, the latest, this person's been fired. Look how the headline is. Netflix fired the organizer of the trans employee walkout. Look how they're already pivoting this, Steph. This is terrifying. This organizer has already stepped into meetings that they weren't supposed to be in, has now leaked private information. You're damn right they're going to get fired. And good job, Netflix. You should. You got to set some more boundaries because apparently the Netflix community is very like kumbaya. We always want to hear your problems and please come to us. And the reality is they're an organization. They're a corporation. At a certain point, they're in charge of how they run their business. You can either choose to work for them or not at the end of the day, right? And if you really believe in it, stop working for them. If you really want to put your money where your mouth is, quit and really cause a real mass walkout. And then let's see what really happens. But no, what's happening right now is we have an organization who I support. I don't want to seem like I'm against anyone, but I'm so sick of a minority group thinking they're more special than anyone else. And that's what the whole idea of Dave Chappelle's special was. He talks about this woman named Daphne Dorman. It's a tragic story. I implore you watch it. I don't want to really spoil it, but I'm going to spoil it in that this was a trans supporter of Dave's who supported the show. And all the activists and people who are angry at Chappelle are like, oh, he had a trans friend, so this justifies what he did. That's not what the story was at all. This woman stepped forward and supported Chappelle. And then when she did that, she was bullied by the community that's trying to pull it off of Netflix. She was bullied so much that she took her own life. Chappelle points this out. It bothered me so much. It made me so upset that her tribe, as he calls it, couldn't deal with it and had to bully her to suicide. Now, there could have been other reasons. That wasn't clearly the only reason, but still, it had to have a part in why it happened. He tells a story, and I found it so sad but also beautiful how much he wants to support her and how impressed he was for going against the curve, right, against the tribe, if you will. And he realized she was in my tribe. She was in the comedian tribe. And so now he's vowed to pay for her family and has set up a trust fund for her kids or her child because he knew how important that was to her. It's so special, and there's so much to it that proves this man's not out to hate any group. He's out to hate the bullies that pushed his friend to that point, Steph. That's what it was about to me. And yes, does he make some offensive jokes about the community? Yes. They do a whole thing about him. He goes and defends J.K. Rowling's right to say, I believe in biological gender. Look, I'm uneducated on this topic. I need to get more educated, and I would love if someone in the community wants to come talk to me privately, publicly, whatever. Please, I'm all ears. I'd love to speak to someone rationally about this topic. I don't know enough about the J.K. Rowling problem, but I know she believes in biological gender. I know a lot of people do. Anyone who believes in that is suddenly termed TERF. So Chappelle said, yeah, I guess I'm team TERF because he believes in biological gender. Doesn't mean he doesn't believe in rights or that the people who are trans aren't women. He never says anything like that, except that's how everyone sort of paints it after the fact. And I bring this all summary up together because, guys, this is scary. This is scary for everything. I think it's scary because I think it's going to cause more hate to this group that I support and I think needs to be... They need to relax on the censorship. They need to be more keen on the education and talk to us versus constantly try to cancel us because he has difference of opinions and he makes jokes. I think that's stepping so backwards as a society. And I think this is important. This whole topic is so important because I can tell you now exclusively, I don't think anyone else is reporting this, Steph. He was at a show last night. He's promoting this documentary, Dave Chappelle. And while I don't believe he can get canceled because the audience is always going to support him, I have someone who was at that event, who was at a premiere at Leicester Square in UK, near you, not too far from you, in the UK. He was premiering his new documentary. He walked out and he mentioned that two festivals disinvited his film from their festivals, one of which is a major New York festival. He didn't name them. But now he's struggling to get this documentary out there. He also made a point this documentary has nothing to do with, you know, the controversy right now. It's about COVID. It's about Black Lives Matter. It's about how we tried to do this thing in Ohio and how the community and the affected the pandemic. I'm told the documentary is beautiful. That my colleague who saw it says it's great. Chris Rock, Kevin Hart, a lot of amazing people doing sets in it. But the industry now won't touch it with a 10-foot pole. They're all afraid to work with them because this group is playing hardball and they're getting headlines like this, which it's like, they fired the trans employee who led the walk-off. You mean the employee who broke protocol and shared private information? Yeah, that employee deserves to be fired. Why are we making this like some sort of hate crime is what this sounds like to me, Steph. Because Netflix has the guts, thank God, to be like, sorry, you don't get special treatment. You don't get to complain louder than everybody else. You broke the trust and the rules of working here, so you're fired. You did it twice. You had a warning, and then you did it again. Then you shared our private budget information publicly. Yeah, you're right, but your ass, you're fired. But the media's not going to say that, Steph. They're going to say, oh, well, they fired the organization of the walkout. Oh, they're anti this group. Steph, this is terrifying, and this is bullying tactics. That's what the whole special was. He was proving and pointing a mirror to this group, that this minority of the group, I'm not talking the whole trans community, don't you dare take me out of context here like you're taking him out of context, but this loud minority who is saying, pull his special from Netflix, how dare you? To me, you guys are also part of the problem. You really are. Where were you when Daphne was getting bullied? Where were you to sort of condemn that type of behavior? Where were you to support her and say, look, we may disagree, but please, you know we still support you. Where is that attention, Steph? It's never there. It's always, Chappelle's the bad guy because I haven't watched the whole special, but I'm told he is. And J.K. Rowling isn't allowed to think that because I have rights. She never said you don't have rights. I'm getting so frustrated by this misinformation, by people being painted in negative ways. I'm sure there's a lot of hateful people out there that deserve the hate, but I need to be, please, someone out there. If I'm missing something, by, I implore you, please reach out to me, especially if you're in the trans community. I would love to have a real conversation about this because I don't believe anyone is. I believe everyone's so afraid to have this conversation. And then when you do and you say anything wrong, you're vilified as phobic and you're against the community. It really is scary because I think that's going to do more damage to the community because you're going to anger a lot of people who are going to be uneducated and afraid how to act, what to do. You're pulling my Chappelle off the air? Well, then F you. That's what's going to end up happening because we're not having actual conversations. We can't have disagreements. And I want to wrap up this clip so we can get out there because I want to get your thoughts on all this. Channing Tatum has now weighed into it. He's defended Chappelle, but his comment was here. I want to read it. I understand that Dave is a very dangerous person to talk about at the moment. I understand and hate that he has so hurt so many people with things he has said. But any human can hurt someone, usually because they're hurt. But any human can heal and heal others just the same. This little piece healed me back in the day, and I can't forget that. I was a soft kid, the comedian said in the clip. Oh, wait, hold on. He talks about the star's words came along with a repost of comedian D.L. Hughley, who shared a clip from Chappelle's 2019 special Kennedy Center Honors when he accepted the Mark Twain Prize for American Humor. In the clip, Chappelle discusses how some words of wisdom from his mother led him to stand up. I was a soft kid, the comedian says. I was a sensitive. I'd cry easily. I would be so scared. I'd be scared to fist fight. My mother used to tell me this one thing. Son, sometimes you have to be a lion so you can be the lamb you really are. I talk this shit like a lion. I'm not afraid of any of you. When it comes word to word, I will gab with the best of them just so I can chill and be me. And that's why I love my art form, because I understand every practitioner of it. Whether I agree with them or not, I know where they're coming from. They just want to be heard. They've got something to say. There's something they noticed. They want to be understood. I love this genre. It saved my life. The Magic Mike concluded the start by saying, this does not excuse anything hurtful, though, to be clear. But he's out there sort of trying to prove that, look, there's more to everything you hear. There's more to Chappelle. We shouldn't sorry, I thought you guys were seeing the screen. We shouldn't be labeling or mislabeling him based on what you think he's saying in his jokes to define the man. And we shouldn't assume he has any hate in his body from it. All of this backlash and everything that's growing, it's a powder keg, Steph, that's exploding. And it's so frustrating because I want to support this community, but I can't support this activist who is out there leaking private information, running into meetings they're not supposed to be in, trying to demand that this be pulled from Netflix. I can't support that. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. So now am I suddenly against this community, Steph? What final thoughts on this as I clip, and then we can talk a little bit more on the live. What do you think we should do as a society here?
Not cancel people when you disagree with them. Have a conversation instead. You know, I'm an atheist existentialist. What that means at its core is that I recognize the freedom of all people to be who they want to be. Green, black, blue, gay, lesbian, trans, whatever, right? You have that freedom to be who you want to be, right? I have the freedom to be who I want to be. I also have the freedom to say what I want to say and vice versa. Does that mean that whatever I say, if you disagree with it, that automatically gives you the right to cancel me and vice versa? No, it doesn't. So instead of you thinking, oh, I disagree with that person, they were offensive, right, automatic cancellation, have a conversation. Try and understand their point of view. And allow them the opportunity and the freedom and the right to understand your position as well. Whether you end up agreeing to disagree or going away with a better understanding of each other, ain't that a better outcome rather than this violence of cancel culture? Because make no mistake, cancel culture is a violent act. It's an extremely violent act. And for all you BS liberals out there trying to sing Kumbaya and make the world a better place by using cancellation culture as your weapon of choice. Nah, you can sing Kumbaya all you want out of your backside, because that's just absolutely contradictory at that point. Because what you're using is a method of violence against another human being to cancel them. And that's absolutely outright disgusting. And you all should be ashamed of yourselves.
There you go. We got lots more to talk about, and I see some people in the community want to join our chat. I'm going to happily open up and have this conversation with you guys. I'd love to keep this conversation going. I want to clip this, though, for YouTube so you can have the update on Chappelle. I hope you guys will support this so we can talk more about issues like this, as well as just other missing. We want to cover other news here, so we're planning to. I hope you'll support it if you made it this far. What you can do help is smash that like button, share the video, make sure if you haven't already, hit the bell for all alerts so we can give you more of our points of view and hopefully hear yours too. I think that's what's missing right now. We're clipping this for YouTube, but we're not done the live show. Sometimes we pivot. You never know what we're going to talk about. Make sure not to miss us live every weekday, 12 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. If you're watching live, don't go anywhere.